Hey there people, how are you doing? And it is finally time for the first photo comparison of the iPhone 12. Man, I've been waiting all year for this. I don't know how many of you have been this anticipated, but I sure have. And this time, we're comparing the iPhone 12 against the Note 20 Ultra. And I know, the price differences are pretty huge, but essentially, the iPhone 12 and 12 Pro have the exact same main and ultra-wide cameras, also the selfie camera is the same. So, end of the day, I don't think the iPhone 12 has many differences against the 12 Pro. Of course, the iPhone doesn't have zoom and there are some things missing here and there, but yeah, let's see how it fares. First image, and here, well, there are some things that I want to point out first and foremost. The Note 20 Ultra is far brighter, while the iPhone 12, it does have better highlight control, but what caught my eye the most is that the iPhone 12 looks exactly, and by that I mean just picture perfect, no pun intended, to just how the scene looked to my eyes. I don't think I've seen any smartphone do that. I mean, this amount of realism, it's stunning to say the least. The Note on the other hand, it looks nice, but looking at it, I don't really think it portrays the same look and feel that I saw and the iPhone 12 saw. So, apparently, the iPhone 12 is just as good as your eyes. I'm not exactly sure which one I should go for. On one hand, I love the iPhone 12's realism. On the other, the Note 20 has slightly better shadows and the vibrance is amazing. So, yeah, I'm a little torn on this. Let me know in the comments which one you guys prefer, the realism or the vibrance. Now, in this one, I don't think I have to say it because the Note clearly looks better. The iPhone 12, I think it's screwed up. It didn't exactly do the HDR thing that it does and is like known for doing so well. So, yeah, let's just call this a one-time screw-up. Now for this one, same story. The iPhone 12, insanely realistic. It's almost realistic to a fault because clearly the shadows are better exposed on the Note. But you know, on the iPhone, you can look at it and clearly say that, yes, the sun was about to set, it was dusk, and yeah, I mean, it portrays the feel and look of the image so well, it's stunning. Now, ideally, I'd go for the Note, but once again, I'm kind of torn, so yeah, do let me know in the comments which one you guys prefer, because I'd love to know. Now, this image is kind of interesting, because it's very similar on both, actually, but the iPhone does have a little bit more blown highlights, but what caught my eye the most is the color of the road, because clearly, the Note kind of messed up the color over there on the road, and yeah, the road looks exactly like it did on the iPhone, but not even a little bit like it did on the Note, so yeah, for that reason, I'm going with the iPhone on this one. Now, moving on to the main camera. Here, again, same story. The iPhone 12 has much better color representation for the road. But one thing caught my eye much later is that if you look at that building, like right far off ahead, it's kind of overexposed on the iPhone, but the Note is doing a much, much better job in keeping it under check. So, yeah. I want to call this one a tie because the dynamic range is clearly better on the Note. Now, let's go on to 5x zoom on both. By the way, the iPhone 12 can only do 5x digital zoom. It cannot go any further. On the other hand, the Note 20 Ultra, its maximum zoom range is up to 50 times, which is, yeah, it's going to end up being garbage, but 5x zoom looks tremendously good, as you'd expect. I mean, Note 20 Ultra has 5x optical zoom. It's lossless, so this kind of quality is expected. Now, this is the last outdoor shot, and once again, same story here, but I do think the iPhone kind of underexposed a little. On the other hand, the Note, it's maintaining the exposure a little bit better, but do keep in mind, this is the 108 megapixel mode for the Note 20 Ultra, and yeah, as we already know, the 108 megapixel mode kind of diminishes the overall dynamic range of the photograph, so moving on to the normal 12 megapixel mode on the Note, you can see the dynamic range just jumped up a few notches right there, but yeah, at this point it kind of looks a little unrealistic because the sun was about to set, and yeah, the Note, it almost looks like it's bright and early, but on the iPhone, a little bit underexposed, so I think, in a way, I kind of prefer the 108 megapixel mode because that one had that realistic feel to the photograph. Now, I know I'm yapping on and on about realism and whatnot, but let's face it, the iPhone 12 does it best. In this case, especially, you can see it looks exactly like how it looked to my eyes. No phone to date that I've used has been able to do this. It's kind of crazy using an iPhone for the first time and just looking at this insanely good realism that it can produce. And as expected, on the Note 20 Ultra, we have a little bit better shadow detail overall when it comes to the 12 megapixel mode over the 108 megapixels. So yeah, ideally I would always prefer to use a 12 megapixel mode because it gives a little bit better dynamic range and, you know, it looks a little bit better. Now once again, we're moving on to 5x zoom on both of them, and yeah, clearly the Note once again just insane in this department. I don't think there are many phones out there that can even compete against the Note 20 Ultra's zoom capabilities. Now moving on to 10x on the Note 20 Ultra, we can't even do that on the iPhone 12. And yeah, for good reason, it has no zoom camera. But now for 20x zoom, here, once again, Note 20 Ultra, amazing. 20x zoom is like the sweet spot. You go any further, you're gonna really get a deteriorated image, and that doesn't really look that good. Now moving indoors, this is fairly good lighting. And you know, for now, the iPhone 12 was doing a tremendous job with realism and whatnot, but for some odd reason, it just cannot process the blues in this image that well. The Note, on the other hand, looks exactly like how it did to my eyes, which, well, this twist is kind of interesting if you ask me, because when it came to the outdoor images, in every single one of them, the iPhone did a much better job in producing the exact realistic photograph. Here, not so much. And same story here, the blues on the iPhone, they just don't look that realistic because clearly that's not the blue I used when finishing off this painting. And the Note, on the other hand, very good representation of the exact color of the blues. But one thing you'll notice is that the iPhone looks a lot sharper. It has a lot more realistic detail, and that is because of deep fusion. And deep fusion basically comes into play when it's kind of low light, but not exactly requirement for night mode. So in this case, especially in indoors lighting, diffusion plays an amazing role in making your photographs look just tack sharp. But there is a way to achieve that on the Note 20 Ultra. Since on the Note, we have a night mode, a dedicated one, we can force use night mode and we can get a very similar and highly detailed image like we have on the iPhone 12. Now, of course, the Note 20 Ultra with better colors easily gets my preference here, but yeah, the only point I'm trying to portray over here is that if you want deep fusion on Android, you can try using night mode. You will most probably get a very similar result. Now on this photograph of Valentine, well, the differences are pretty obvious. I wouldn't say either of them is clearly better than the other. Both have very good dynamic range and all that, but the iPhone 12, as you'd expect, slightly flat and a little less contrast, but the Note, on the other hand, higher contrast, more vibrance, and in this case at least, I prefer it because it makes Valentine stand out a little bit more, it makes him look better. So yeah, I'm picking the Note for this one. Now when we go to the ultra wide camera, well, here is where deep fusion really kicks in, because as we already know, indoors using an ultra wide camera, it doesn't really bode well because the quality just isn't that great on the iPhone 12. Since we have deep fusion, it just makes the image look so much more detailed, while the Note, it's kind of blurry. But as I said before, we could use night mode on the Note, and that without question makes the image look just as good, if not a slight bit better than the iPhone 12 even. Now let's move on to some selfies, and here I actually used a full blown studio light just to give the most ideal conditions possible. You know, I wanted to get as close to daylight, and here clearly the iPhone is doing a better job because the Note 20 Ultra, it just makes me look very saturated and kind of yellow, like I've jaundice or whatever. Yeah, I don't have any illness or anything, trust me. So yeah, I'm picking the iPhone for this one. Same story for the portrait selfie here, and once again, I prefer the iPhone, but you know, ideally I would like something between the iPhone 12 and Note 20 Ultra in terms of the vibrance, because I look kind of pale on the iPhone. But nonetheless, other than that, the color differences, I'd say that the edge detection and all that, it's very similar, if not the exact same on both of them. And now, just for the fun of it, I turned around and took the same kind of selfie. And it's just to test out just how far can the dynamic range be tested on both these phones. Clearly, the iPhone 12 is much, much better because, I mean, I barely have any noise on my face. Not only the fact that I'm brighter, but the fact that I have so much better detail on my face and my shirt, it's tremendously good on the iPhone. Given the circumstances, of course. I'm not saying it's a realistic scenario, but well, if dynamic range is something you're really interested in on the front camera, the iPhone 12 does it better. Once again, I don't think I have to say this because the skin tones just look tremendously good on the iPhone. The Note, it makes me look kinda red, and this time I don't know which disease I have, but yeah, Note 20 Ultra just doesn't want me to keep safe. Anyways, the iPhone 12 obviously, the easy choice over here because man, those skin tones are crazy. Same story for this one. This is a very high dynamic range photograph because there's this super bright studio light shining right on one side of my face, and both are doing a fairly good job, but surely because of just how good the iPhone 12 skin tones are, I'm picking that one. The Note 20, once again, that kind of red tint on my face. Also, the highlights a little bit more blown out on the Note. So, yeah, easy choice here once again. Now, we do have night mode on the selfies, so I tried taking this image, and well, the iPhone 12, it doesn't have as much detail as a Note 20 Ultra, but don't mind the colors because that's on me. I used a warm, very dim lamp, and you know, the night mode just amplified that color, and it makes me look like I have blood gushing all over my face. So yeah, don't mind the colors, but detail wise I'd say the Note 20 Ultra is doing a fairly better job in terms of night mode selfie. Now another night mode, and well, it's not insane low light, we'll get to that soon, but I just want to say that the iPhone looks kind of warm. It's not as realistic as it should be, because I've noticed this before. When it goes to night mode, the iPhone 12 always tries to warm up the image a little. The Note, on the other hand, is doing a much better job. You can look at the table, it's a proper white, while the iPhone 12, it's a bit more yellowish. Everything else though, details, colors, it looks just very similar and amazing on both. Now this is an outdoors ultra-wide night mode. That's right, we finally have the amazing night mode on the ultra-wide cameras in iPhones. And yeah, I'm not entirely sure if it's just this scene or what it is, but I took like 10 images on the iPhone 12 but could not get rid of that weird gradient thing that is trying to do to the sky. It just looks weird, and clearly I prefer the Note here. I tried another angle just to see if this problem was constant, but yeah, it's clearly not, because in this image the iPhone 12 has a much better rendition of the gradient of the sky, and it does look a little bit too gray in my opinion. The Note looks a little bit better with the blue. But yeah, other than that, I just want to say that the iPhone has a tremendous night mode, and I just couldn't be happier to have it on the ultra-wide camera as well, because it took long enough, let me tell you. Now, for the main camera night mode, well, this is where the iPhone shines, because the noise reduction on the iPhone 12 when it comes to skies is the best you can get in any smartphone that I've seen so far. Because the Note, it's good, it's very good, but still it has some noise, some artifacting, and I don't know how much YouTube compression will allow you to see, but trust me when I say the iPhone 12 is the cleanest night mode sky that I've seen so far, period. Now for extreme night mode, and here I really wanted to test out which of these two will be able to bring out the blues, because I used a fairly blue light, and the iPhone 12, once again, I think it has some problem with the blues because it always tries to balance it out somehow, and you know, it kind of messes up the colors. The Note, on the other hand, it looks very realistic, and I'd go so far as to say that the Note 20 Ultra handles blues very well indeed, because that is exactly how the scene was set, and with night mode and its tremendous amount of detail and noise reduction, it looks fantastic. The iPhone 12 looks good in all those regards except for the colors. Now just to see if this problem was only confined to the blues, I changed up the color scheme completely. I used a red controller with warm light. It wasn't super warm or anything, but as you can see, the iPhone 12 doing a far better job. The red of the controller is, again, so realistic, it blows my mind. The Note 20 Ultra is doing a good job, but clearly not as accurate as the iPhone 12, because the controller kinda looks scarlet on the Note 20 Ultra, while the iPhone has the perfect red, and man, it looks so good. Alright, that is it for this comparison, and I've had some time to collect my thoughts on this, so here's what I think. The iPhone 12 is an amazing camera, I don't think you'll be disappointed by it. And compared to the iPhone 12 Pro, I don't think you're getting much in terms of the cameras at least. There's only one 2x telephoto zoom camera and a LiDAR scanner, and unless you're really into AR, the LiDAR scanner doesn't really play a huge role. So basically the only extra thing in terms of cameras you're getting for $1,000 is a telephoto camera, and I don't think it's really worth that much. So let's just save the 12 versus 12 Pro comparison for another video, but as compared to the Note 20 Ultra, clearly the Note 20 Ultra has one of the most versatile cameras that I've seen. because it has that amazing zoom with, like, you know, one of the best, highest quality zooming in that you can see with hybrid and optical zooms. It's amazing. When it comes to the main camera, Note 20 Ultra will give you more dynamic, vibrant images with, you know, usually more contrast and whatnot. It'll look like an edited photo. It's not as crazy, as processed as Samsung used to be, but you'll still see that signature. On the iPhone 12, well, as many of you know already, it's gonna be the most realistic photograph when it comes to, like, outdoors daylight images, as you saw here. It's amazing in terms of realism. If that's what you're looking for, the iPhone 12 is easily the way to go. Now, of course, images are only a part of the comparison. The video comparison will be coming out soon enough, so do stay tuned. And then we have portraits, which are, again, just incredible on iPhones. It's been a staple for iPhones with their absolutely insane skin, and, you know, it always comes out looking amazingly well, and this comparison was proof of it. When it comes to night mode though, I think the iPhone still needs some work when it comes to the ultra-wide night mode. It needs to be optimized a little, the noise reduction needs to be adjusted and whatnot, but yeah, I'm pretty sure a few software fixes will help out with that. And another thing that I really want Apple to fix is the way the iPhone 12 handles blues. It usually makes them a little bit more pale, so yeah, I'm hoping that gets fixed soon enough. Other than that, man, the iPhone 12 has an incredible camera. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, do hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will be seeing you guys later. Cheers.